when we're looking for the direction of light, it's easy to say, look for the light. But what I find the easiest thing to do is look for the shadows, and they're going to show you where that light is falling across your subject. And when you are setting up your images, your lighting is so important in terms of where you want your eye to fall in the photograph. The parts of your image that you're lighting, that's going to draw your attention away from the main subject if they're brighter. So for example, if we were photographing a white bucket here and the light was hitting the side of the white bucket first, then it's going to become the brightest part of the image, so it can become distracting. So when we're looking for that direction of light, we want to make sure that it is actually directly hitting the subject of your photograph, so that they are the main focal point, which is what we want our viewer to look at. When I'm setting up a prop or a setup on my posing bag, I'm always looking for that 45 degree angle of light. I want the light to fall gently across the eyebrow of the baby or the side of the face, and then onto the other side of the face, so that those shadows highlight those features. When we have lighting that hits the baby, straight on, we tend to lose all of those shadows, and we tend to flatten out all of those features, so it can look really flat. But when we turn it on an angle, so that we turn the baby away from that light, that's where we start to introduce some shadows, and we can really start to highlight the little nose and cheeks, which is what we want. When we're looking at that direction of light falling across the subject, as we turn the baby away from the light, this is where you can start to see those shadows increase on this side of the face. So depending on that style and mood that you're looking for, that's how you're going to record it. For me, I like to keep it really simple, having that baby on a 45 degree angle towards my light source. As you can see, it's coming in from over here. We're not too close, we have some distance, which means that the light is going to be softer where it's hitting the baby, and it's going to fall gently across those shadows onto the other side of the face. If we tend to move the face away from the light, we can increase the shadows even more on this side, keeping the baby's body at a 45 degree angle. And you can start to play around and get some different varieties of images with that style of lighting. You can even come and shoot back into the light from that shadowy side, and then the highlights work the same as the shadows in terms of highlighting those features. So you can have a lot of fun with lighting in a sense like this, and how to sort of, control the direction of it, and also how you capture it, which can be really interesting and create a very different look in your images without having to move the baby, which is ultimately what you want. When you are setting them up, consider looking at where those shadows are falling and how dark those shadows are, whether or not you need to bring some light in with a reflector and bounce it back into those shadows to fill them, or you need to move your subject further away from the light or closer to the light as well. So yeah, looking for the direction of that light as to where those shadows actually fall on your subject will give you a lot more control over that.
All right. Welcome, everyone. Let's do this.